warm in there. And then we need only half this chilli. I'm going to cut the end off, cut it down the middle. Now, I'm sure you know, but just to remind everyone, don't, whatever you do, touch your hands, touch your eyes or anything on you until after you've completely washed your hands. I'm just going to scrape the seeds out and the red bit. Okay, right, so now we're just going to cut the chilli up. We're going to just dice it and put it in there. Probably a little bit too much chilli just for the one, but you know, it's a large thing, never mind. So it means that each person has got one small spring onion, probably one small chilli. That'll probably do. I'm going to discard this last bit. Right, so now for some salt, just a little bit, and some pepper. Right, so let's put this gas hob on. So I'm going to do medium to high heat. About that. I'm going to put in some olive oil. That's plenty. So now, most importantly, I need to whisk this up. Too much. Gonna put the crumpet in top end in first and press it down just gently so that it starts to absorb the egg. I don't want to break the crumpet, so you have to be gentle. So it's starting to go there. That's me putting too much pressure on. So I'll just start to be a bit more gentle, and I'll wait for my frying pan to heat up. Okay, and I'll try the same thing this way. Now, with the eggs from the supermarket, from Asda's, they've all got the lion's mark on it. So even if we undercook this egg, we can't give ourselves salmonella. But if someone was to do this and they were taking the egg directly from the farm, then they'd have to make sure that they were completely, thoroughly cooking the egg. But we're going to be able to afford to have a slightly wetter one. So I'm putting some of the... I'm putting some of the ingredients, the chilli and the spring onion, back on top of the crumpet. That's probably about ready. And now I'm just going to slide it in now that I've turned it over. Okay. And now I can start to put some of this on top. There we go. I expect it to be sizzling usually, but it's hot at the moment. Now, if we got any, if we had any runoff of the egg, what we'd do is we'd just use a spoon, being careful not to touch the side, and we'll just put it back on as the egg becomes more solid as it cooks it on the side. It's easy just to spoon it back on. But this one, because I think I've had the practice, it hasn't actually had to do that. So I'm going to give that about 3 minutes on one side, and then I'm going to flip it.
Alexa, timer, 3 minutes.
3 minutes.
So how long left on that timer?
You have one timer. A 3-minute timer with about 1 minute left.
Alexa, cancel timer. Alexa, timer 3 minutes. So I'm just going to split this over. That's better. So it's a fairly nice colour. Just going to give it another 3 minutes. Alexa's doing the timing. Alexa, how long left on that timer?
You have one timer. A 3 minute timer with about 1 minute and 10 seconds left.
Okay, so we're in for 2 minutes. I'm just going to check this. And that's looking good. It's a good colour. It's got a surface to it. You can still see that when I squish it down, there's some of the soft egg coming out. So it still needs some cooking time. Let's put this back on for a little longer. Now, some people don't like to have the eggs, be able to see the egg juice or the egg undercooked. I say it's not really a health issue. You know, you can now with the Lion's eggs, the ones from Lasda's and the supermarkets are all, they're all fine. But if we were getting them from a farm, it'd be different. Just give that top section a little bit more. Alexa, stop. Okay. Well, I don't mind my one being a little bit underdone. That's the way I like them. So I'm now going to put this, I'm going to serve this one up. There we go. And let's go and pick. Look. last thing to mention, I'm also serving this with brown sauce and red sauce mixed into one. Makes it taste, it's great, because otherwise it can be a little dry. It works really well. So it's brown sauce and red sauce mixed into one. Okay, look at that, eh? Looks absolutely lovely. Let's try it out. Look at that. So a bit of sauce on this. Oh, really good. Very nice. Well, Merry Christmas to you all, and I hope you have to have a different breakfast at some point, on one of the days at least. Okay. Merry Christmas.